Welcome to DataRobot. The DataRobot AI Platform offers one unified platform for generative and predictive AI. We help you operate with confidence, govern with full visibility, and build with agility. Our customers report 83% faster deployments, a 4.6x return on investment, and 80% lower costs for a typical use case. DataRobot's fully open platform with native integrations gives you the freedom to choose from best-of-breed components. Let's head inside now so you can see it for yourself. From the homepage, select Workbench for building AI, Registry for governing AI, and Console for operating AI. Also from the homepage, access hands-on tutorials and links to what's new. You always have the choice of working inside the GUI or interacting with DataRobot through the REST API or our SDKs for R and Python users. Let's run this starter use case with the wall clock running to back up the productivity and ROI claims. I'm navigating to Workbench and creating a new use case folder. Then I'll add a notebook asset to the use case and import the starter notebook by pasting the GitHub URL. Using a few dropdowns, I'll configure the notebook environment without having to concern myself with low-level infrastructure. I select two CPUs and a pre-built Python environment and start the container. This use case predicts flight delays. The notebook imports, wrangles, registers, and does EDA on a dataset. Then, DataRobot starts developing model pipelines and shows us the performance and recipe of the winner. The top model is then registered and deployed to an API endpoint. Finally, new data is streamed to the deployment and usage metrics are requested. I just clicked Run Notebook, and now we can follow the entire build, govern, operate flow. It's about a 15-minute process on commodity hardware. The implication is that this use case can be retrained and redeployed daily. But the automation that DataRobot provides isn't just about speed. It's about resilient pipelines too. The DataRobot API allows your teams to write less code. Therefore, processes become more standardized and less likely to break down. I talked over the data upload and the EDA to get to the good stuff. This cell is reporting on the modeling tasks completed and queued. DataRobot handles the queue management and parallelizes the work for you. As the expert, you can skip ahead to reviewing the results as if you had a large team running experiments and aggregating their findings. 10 experiments are complete. They include coefficient-based models, such as GAM and ElasticNet, and non-parametric models such as XGBoost and Keras RNNs. Printed to the screen, we see that the top model is a rule-fit classifier with an AUC of 0.66. In the table, the three most important features are the date, scheduled departure time, and flight number. The full pipeline, including data pre-processing, involves one-hot encoding, missing value imputation, and word n-gram counting. These were all part of the queue management we saw earlier and did not need to be individually specified. These three deployment-related cells handle the model registration, the creation of the API endpoint, and the configuration of observability metrics. This is an extremely high level of abstraction that disguises the true complexity of model deployments. In this starter example, we operate the model by sending it a local data frame to score. In practice, you would use the scheduler to set up a recurring batch job, all with alerts and notifications. Having scored some data, deployment monitoring metrics are now available. Printed to screen is the total number of predictions made, the target drift, and the feature drift. It's 16 minutes later, and I want to show the analytical results to a business leader or business analyst. I also want to show that the model is properly documented and operating without errors to my boss. I return to the Workbench use case folder. the data files generated from the notebook are registered for lineage purposes. The 10 models developed are inside this experiment. I can share visuals of the data pipeline and the feature impact with the line of business by sharing access through DataRobot or by downloading charts. In the registry, today's work is registered as V1 for predicting takeoff delays, and all model metadata is recorded. In the console, the deployment is listed alongside 61 others. My actions are entered into the deployment history log. The status of the endpoint is green, and the test batch is visible. All the observability monitoring has been instrumented correctly. Well done, DataRobot. To recap, you just saw a full build, govern, operate ML lifecycle using simple commands such as these three. And you got to glimpse how code-first data scientists and ML engineers collaborate with other team members because everything done in code is synced to the GUI. Having done a little bit of showing off, I hope you're excited to explore DataRobot more deeply. Use the first link for more video content. Use the second link for a live personalized demonstration. Use the third link to start a free trial today.